finished my CT test and I'm waiting now to complete my blood test. We'll see what will be the reports tomorrow morning, and from there I'll have to decide. The doctor will tell whether I need to get admitted or not.
Get this complaints commonly. That we want to remove you site and very wrong readings counting because our nation is quite accurate with the medical grade equipment. Need the path to phone and create the medical equipment. We have added one extra, two extra medicines.
So time is now around 11 AM on 15th of October. Feeling very tired already. So that's the only thing, I'm feeling constantly tired and cough is also really high. So the doctor just came and had an inspection with me. She asked my previous history and all that. So I spoke to her, gave her my instructions. And I'm currently resting in my bed. So yeah, that's it. I'm waiting each time and see what to do next.
Blood test edhu kudukalalla
aha neethu kudutha ka
neethu kudutha
aama athu blood test CT moon test kudutha CLR hey kee
thangalum
பெயின் இருக்கு உனக்கே தருங்க
They just put antibiotic and you're not allowed to rub on that area where they injected. But it's paining like shit, man. I asked what that injection was. She said it's antibiotic. When you're not.
So it's been 2 hours since I came to the hospital. So now they put this saline and they put some injections.
And you can see the mark over here for the antibody which they had injected. And they just gave a newspaper for me to read.
So the only thing is going to be like, you know, how long this is gonna take. Currently I'm feeling really better than what I was feeling like 3-4 hours ago. Yeah, so I just need to keep myself entertained, not get bored watching TV again and again. We'll see what to do. But yeah, I'm really thankful that they gave really nice view. Coolest thing ever. Okay, so got our first lunch. I mean, day one lunch. There's some white rice with some vegetable, and then there is some salad in this, and curd and the chicken gravy, and I guess that's some papad. And so it is 4:30 right now on October 15th. The fever is like 102 degrees, burning like anything. The thing with COVID is that the fever comes in intervals and it goes. It is not like standard. Like, it'll come for 1 hour, 2 hours, and it'll go. So I waited for a hour. The doctor waited for a hour. The fever didn't reduce, so they gave a para injection, it seems, which will help me in reducing body temperature. I can't tell you how my ears are burning, like as if they're on fire. Damn, this is so much pain, man. I just cannot believe this. 45 minutes ago, I was completely out. I was like, I'm gonna be sick like this. You know, my body temperature was close to 102, and I was like, you know, my entire day is gonna be like this, and my body is gonna keep hurting. But what happened is, at 4:40, the nurse came, and she came to check on me, and I said I'm having a lot of body temperature, and it's burning a lot. I don't know what they gave. I know they gave some injection. Within 45 minutes, I can literally, you know, I'm out of my bed right now. Like, for the last 2 hours, I was on my bed, unable to go even to the washroom. My body was hurting so much, and it was burning so much. I thought, like, you know, dude, the entire day is gone. It's going to be, like, so shitty like this. But right now, I can see a lot of difference. I'm able to walk suddenly. And the senior doctor called me, and he said, like, you know, this is going to continue. The fever is going to continue. And he's going to give me another injection so that this doesn't come again or this reduces. So he said, probably in 2 days, the fever thing will reduce. I just had some snacks over here. I had some milk, Horlicks, and they gave bonda with chutney, but I didn't want to try anything oily, so I just left it off. I called them right now, and I asked for a chicken soup because I'm feeling so fresh right now. It almost feels like as if I had a great sleep and I woke up. So yeah, back to enjoying the view. p.m. October 15th, feeling all right. Got my body temperature checked. It is 98, although 98 is supposed to be, you know, a higher number. I don't feel anything, so I'm just watching Garfield movie. It's been so many years since I watched TV. Like, literally, I watch everything on my phone. It's quite funny that I'm watching Star movies now, along with that breaks and all that. Okay, I'm just gonna wait for a hour and watch out for RCB versus Kings 11 Punjab. Hoping Kings 11 Punjab win, because I don't want RCB to win, so that the IPL table can be open. Nothing personal. Well, this is gonna be a great match. Like, seeing Chris Gayle back in the squad is something exciting for all fans. Let's see how this match is gonna go. 7:30 now, kickoff time for cricket. So this is the dinner. The time is now 16th of October.
1 AM exactly when RCB was playing their innings. I think I saw Virat Kohli or somebody in 18th over, and I felt sick after that. Like, I couldn't even see TV. I was like, I started knowing that my body is getting kind of cold, you know, like it was freezing, my body was freezing. And I called the nurse and I informed her. From 9 PM to until 1 AM, my body temperature was shifting between 103 to 99. It was so painful. In fact, when I got a 99, from 102 point something to 99, due to the temperature falling down quickly, like, you know, there's a huge difference from 102 point something to 99. So my body started shivering, like, you know, as if I got fits. I could still remember that, like, I had three nurses who came and, you know, were holding my legs, and another nurse was holding my body so that I stopped this shivering. It was literally like I got fits or something. Horrible, horrible experience. Now it's 1 PM. Now I'm feeling much better. Last 3-4 hours was torture. Oh god. So yeah, I'm going back to sleep now. My entire body temperature, everything is normal right now. I can just have a nice sleep, wake up in the morning, and we'll see how it goes from there. So October 16th, 7 AM. So right now I should have been on a trip, you know, like I was having a plan to go to Kodaikanal with a couple of my friends, but instead I'm stuck in hospital getting treated for corona. Thank god, you know, I tested before going to the trip, so that the trip would have been bad and I might have even passed on corona to them. So it's 7 AM. I woke up today and I was speaking to dad, telling him the story what happened last night, pretty much that. And now I got, so here I got some badam to eat, milk, and then this kashayam. So I'll have to go eat all this right now and we'll see what will be the next thing. So it's 8 AM now. I just received my breakfast. I'm gonna see what's there. So we have an omelette over here, and then we have some fruits. Guess this is normal chutneys. Okay, now what's inside? What's inside is mint idli. Okay, and then we have some vegetable filled dosas, like masala dosa. Okay, it's been long since I tried mint idli. I'm going to have my breakfast now. So it's 12 PM right now, super bored. I'm just sitting by the window trying to see, you know, what's outside. Just watching all the vehicles go. I guess this is the only time pass for now. I'm bored of watching TV. And yeah, those are the eagles which are coming close by to the window sometimes. But yeah, super bored, man. One thing I found is, like, you know, there's a some bike racing kind of track over here. What does it say? SUV challenge track. Wow. So yeah, this is being my view and this is being my time pass right now. I'm not interested in watching TV or my phone or anything. Hope time flies by soon. Also, really better. I'm not having any
symptoms except than some mild cough, not having any body temperature or anything. So all's cool on that end. Yeah. So it is 1 p.m. right now on Friday. Not too hungry though. The lunch has arrived. And so what's in lunch is chicken gravy and salad. This is some roti. What's this? Okay, this is mint rice with some dal and all that. Okay, we'll go ahead and start digging. October 16, 3 p.m. check. So the duty doctor had come and he had done some normal tests on me, and my oxygen level is on 99%, which is extremely good. He checked up on me if I have any other issues. I said that I'm feeling normal, no other issues, but I'm having some heavy hair loss. You know, like I never seen this much hair loss happen to me before, so I just notified about it. And he said he will consult with the doctor and get back to me, the senior doctor, and get back to me. Otherwise, I'm not feeling much, pretty much anything negative. Everything is good. I'm feeling like it's normal. No body temperature, no body pains, nothing. But I wanted to take a bath, but they suggested that I don't. One is because of this, which is on my hand. And secondly, they told, like, since I'm having body temperature up and down, they said not to take a bath. Rather, they would you know, ask the nurse to give me a body wash. But I felt very uncomfortable with that idea, so I said I would just rather wait for a couple of more days before I could take a bath. Since it's already a closed environment in an AC room, so it doesn't feel much sweaty and stuff, so I think I can wait for 2-3 days more before I can take my bath myself. So I'm continuing watching YouTube now, so bored. Think about this is that, like, you need to keep yourself motivated or engage in some kind of stuff. I had some other works which I needed to do. So luckily I got my laptop. I just finished some of those works and I'm back to resting again. Yeah. 3:30 p.m. right now. My snacks has arrived. So I was speaking to the doctor now because I've been having some issues with my motions. So he said need to avoid the milk items, so maybe I'm gonna stop taking milk except for the night. And now what we got in snacks is, okay, there is samosa for snacks, so I'm going to enjoy it now. Okay, honestly, for a minute I was excited that I'm going to eat samosa. I thought, you know, that's going to be this masala stuffing, but no, that's far from reality. So there is some moong dal type, you know, some dal kind of type. So I guess these are the healthy types that they're trying to give me in my diet. Okay, maybe masala can wait for a little time now. I'll continue eating this healthy kind of samosa. So I just ordered papaya juice. The Swiggy guy is coming to deliver it. So it is 6:30 p.m. right now on a Friday. I haven't had any major health issues right now. I'm just like relaxing. My fever and my body temperature has come down to like 95-96, which is pretty much normal. But the doctor said that you know, I can expect another wave of fever, so he's given me medicines for that, which I should be taking in the night. My cough is also a bit slightly reoccurring, so he's given me syrup for that. Other than that, pretty much I've done nothing the entire day. Just sat by the window, watched the roads. It's dark right now, so I didn't watch much of TV also. I just turned on the TV because the IPL match, Mumbai Indians and KKR match, is going to start. Yeah, so pretty much it's been very normal day. So the doctor spoke to me, said that I asked the reason, you know, why I'm being given steroids, because I thought steroids is usually for you know, very serious kind of cases. To which the doctor said that my CRP level is slightly on the higher side,
close to medium, more than medium. So that is why he said that he's trying to give me steroids, but he said that he's going to give me in lesser volume so that it doesn't have much of effect. But because of steroids, I'm kind of having a bad stomach, and suddenly my hair is falling off so quickly. Like, I just comb my hair, or even if I touch it, I can see at least some 10 to 15 strands of hair falling off. So I just informed that to the doctor. So after this, I will be having my lunch. I'm sorry, I'll be having my dinner, and I'll be going back to quick sleep. Only thing which I hope is that I wish I don't have this really bad experience which I had yesterday. Like, my body started shivering and I couldn't sleep. I'm really hoping that that doesn't repeat for today. Yep, bye-bye.
அந்த முதல் நாள் எனக்கு உடம்பு ஆடணும் இப்போ நீங்கள் தானே இருந்துச்சு அன்னைக்கு பயங்கரமாக
okay, good morning. So this is October 17th, Saturday, 6:30 a.m. So I had a pretty much good sleep. I didn't have any trouble. I don't remember, you know, having any kind of issue, my cough or fever, or there's no body pains or anything. I feel completely normal, although there is a bit of, you know, discomfort over here in the cough region, in the throat region. Still, you know, that is quite negligible, or I could say that seeing my father's experience having COVID, I could say that, you know, this is going to continue for 30 days or 40 days, this discomfort in throat and all that. But otherwise, yes, I had a great sleep. I just love the fact that, you know, day before yesterday was a nightmare, and yesterday's sleep was really good. So I'm very, very happy about it, that I had a great sleep. One issue is that, like, I've been taking steroids right now in the treatment, because the treatment requires me to take steroids, and because of that, the sugar levels in my body have gone really high, up to 300 plus. So they have given me, first they gave me an round of insulin, but after that, again, after they tested after 3-4 hours, my sugar levels didn't go down. It was still about 280 to 90 from 320 or something. So that was quite a bit worryful. So they gave me a second round of injection around 8 p.m. after my dinner. So I slept off by 10 p.m. I'm not able to watch any IPL matches. That is something so funny, because I love watching IPL, but right now I'm falling off sick. I mean, I'm falling off tired. So I'm kind of going to sleep very early. So what happened is at 4 a.m. I guess, the nurse came and she just checked my sugar levels. At that time it was about again close to some mid ranges of 200. So I she told me the results and she went and I was like, oh, why is this? You know, sugar levels not dropping. So that was quite a bit, you know, worrying me at 4 a.m. But I was like, okay, I'm sleepy. Let me go to sleep. And now again at 6:30, just I woke up and now they came and tested me for the sugar levels, and it shows that you know, it has come down close to normal. It is not normal, but just close to normal by 130. So normal ranges from 90 to 100, but I have come to 130. So that's still decent, because given the you know, given the fact that I'm taking steroids and I'm also having insulin, so 130 is a decent number. But okay, yeah. Now the good thing is that, like, the in Chennai on a Saturday morning, it's raining heavily. You could see that raindrops on the glasses, and the picture of, you know, this cloudy, gloomy kind of thing itself is very satisfying to see. Yeah, so I guess I'll be having some nice time, you know, looking outside the window and while away my day. Ooh. So it is 1 p.m. right now. Time for so today's lunch. I got some veg pulao or veg biryani. I don't know how to term it. And there is fish over here with some dal and roti and salad over here. So yeah, I think pretty much normal now. Everything seems to be okay, but my digestion, again, my stomach, I'm having some stomach issues. They gave me steroids in the morning, and because of that I'm having these steroid issues, and my sugar levels continue to shoot up beyond 350 right now, which is quite scary. But the doctor is telling me not to be scared about it, because they're going to reduce my steroid intake by almost half by tomorrow, since I'm recovering very well. So the doctor said, like, you know, for next 1 month it might look high, and after that I need to continue having a good diet and I need to exercise so that I can bring it under control. So going forward, you know, I should be focusing more on how much I eat, because I also need to eat everything which has a lot of higher protein. So yeah, pretty much that's it. I'm feeling normal. I'm just feeling a bit lazy to take a bath, or else I should take one today or maybe tomorrow. That's it. Bye. They did a blood test, and it shows that I have some CRP levels high. It is something related to the infections. So I'm continuing taking steroids and related antiviral injections, which is going on. So right now I'm able to, you know, like, use only my left hand, because previously this was on my left hand, but I started feeling a lot of discomfort, so they had to change it to my right hand now. But yeah, it's going to be very hard to use a phone or eat in and left hand, but I got no choice. And I took a bath today finally on the fourth day, and I feel really fresh. That's it. I had my breakfast, I had upma, and I had some eggs. I'm just gonna sleep for a little while, and then see what to do after next. So it is Sunday, about 7 p.m. now. Quietly, you know, like, you know, slightly I'm disturbed right now mentally, because I feel really well, I feel like normal and all that, but since morning there's been a lot of blood reports that have been taken, and the infection level, the CRP levels haven't gone down, which is quite worrying. In fact, the doctor said it was slightly higher than before. So that was little, you know, disappointing, because I feel so normal. I thought, you know, I'll be out in 2-3 days or something like that. But since morning I had some 8 hours of medicine going into my nerve. So for 8 hours I had to keep my hands still,
and I'm kind of getting angry and being so frustrated being in the room. I don't know what to do, but dad, I was speaking to dad. Dad was like, be more patient. You need to be more positive about it. It seems there might be some delay in me getting out of the hospital because CRP levels will take more than some time to lower. And when I found out about my issue, it was probably the day one. So dad is kind of suggesting that it'll take more than 6-7 days for the CRP levels to actually go down. So I'm very, very frustrated being in the hospital. Although the food is good, the stay is pleasant and all that, I just want to go home and like, I feel normal, but the reports tell it's not normal. I have a bit more of infection and my insulin levels, sugar levels are really high. No matter what I don't eat or eat, because of the steroids which I'm taking, it's going beyond 300 and all that, and that's running in my mind continuously. And even though the doctor is coaching me, telling me not to worry about it, it's really worrying though. I don't know what to do. Maybe I have to be positive. That's all I can keep telling myself. Good morning today. So it's October 19th. Yeah, it's October 19th, Monday. 7 a.m. Good thing today is that my sugar levels have shown better improvement. Usually it was showing around 200, 300, something like that, but it came down to 140 today. I'm still continuing the medicines and all this steroids and all that is going on. But yeah, I feel happy that, you know, the sugar levels are lower today. So today I was thinking, like, you know, I could ask permission to walk around the corridor because it's a huge building. So I thought, I'm so bored being in the room for almost 5-6 days now. I don't even remember how many days I've been here. So I thought I'll ask nurse permission, either I can walk or probably I could just walk inside the room. Yeah, otherwise nothing else. I'm bored, trying to be positive. I have no idea how to be positive. Just watching a lot of TV now. That's the only entertainment. Otherwise, it's been going normal, getting my routine injections and all that. That's it. So, finally, good news. The doctor had called and said that they are discharging me tomorrow because my treatment is getting over tomorrow. It doesn't mean that I'm not. I am COVID negative. It means that my treatment part is done. And I asked the doctor if I could go to my hometown, which is like 280 kilometers from Chennai. It would be some 4 to 5 hour drive. The doctor said no, because it seems there are more than 20 to 30% of chances of me getting the, having some complications about COVID, because it's just like the sixth day today since I had the symptoms, and the virus or the fever can be until up to 14 to 20 days. So he said he can't risk me going out of city, leaving the state. So he wants me to stay within the city, quarantining for the next 2 weeks. So yes, finally getting out of the hospital. Feels happy first that, you know, my treatment and all that stuff is done. But going forward, I need to be more careful. That's what the doctor said, like, you know, don't be too excited that you're going outside the hospital. So I'm going to continue my quarantining period next, because it's just been 6 days since I got COVID, and the COVID is likely to be a life of 14 days and all that thing. So the doctor has said me to be very careful for the next 14 days, not to venture out anywhere, continue self-quarantining. So I'm pretty much safe, you know, like the doctor says that there is only 10% or less chance for me to again have COVID or some kind of complications. So he wants me to stay within the city, which I'm completely fine with. So yeah, I'm normal. I feel extremely well. I'm happy, healthy. I can run, talk. I don't have a cough issue anymore. Everything seems to be normal. So yes, thank you, MGM Hospital and the nurses and the staff members, cleaning, food people and the doctors, everybody.